Hi guys, welcome to QA Tech Talks. In this video, I'll be covering about Cypress setup and installation local environment. To getting started with Cypress, we need prerequisites such as Node.js, VS Code IDE, basic JavaScript functions, and knowledge of how to use the loops, conditions, arrays, objects. And I will be covering about basic JavaScript video in the coming series. And finally, we need Cypress installation in local environment. Here you can see a bit comparison between the top IDEs from VS Code, Sublime, Atom, Vim, and Notepad++. Here you can see user experience, performance, extensibility, learning curve, and overall VS Code is on top as A grade, and second Sublime is on with B+. And Atom is B. And for JavaScript automation or development, VS Code is the most recommended IDE for everyone. Let's see a quick demo. And to install Node.js from website, we can go to nodejs.org and we can download the LTS version, which stands for long-term stable version. Or we can use the current version with latest features. But the highly recommended one for most users is the LTS version. Here you can see Node.js is a JavaScript runtime built on Chrome's V8 JavaScript engine. Node.js is mainly a proxy between the Cypress browser and the web. It is a middle layer between the environment. And to install Node.js on Mac, we have a homebrew package manager, which is easy to install with the commands such as, once we download the homebrew, we can run the command brew install node. With this single command, we can download the Node.js in the Mac environment. And for Windows, there is a good package manager such as Chocolate Hay. Using this package manager, we can download the modules or packages from remote repository via command line, which is good for Windows users. And to download the VS Code, we can go to the code.visualstudio.com website, and we can download the based on the operating system Mac, Windows, and Linux. It supports all the operating systems, and it's easy to use and maintain. And VS Code is one of the top IDEs for JavaScript, and we can use for any other environment as well, language as well, Java or Python, any other programming language. And once we install the Node.js from website or from package manager, we can run the command node version to make sure it is successfully installed in the local environment. Here you can see it was installed with the version 13.11.0. Once we can check with the npm version as well with the command npm --version. So I have installed 6.13.7 in my local environment. So we have node and npm now. So we are good to go with the Cypress installation. Here npm is the node package manager. Using the node package manager, we can download multiple node modules from the central repository. I will show a brief demo about the how to install in the couple of minutes. Let me open VS Code IDE. Here you can see the welcome screen of the VS Code IDE with the start, create a new file, open folder, or add workspace folder. And we can open the recent workspace folders. And there are how to getting started with the VS Code IDE. I will be covering about the usage of VS Code and shortcuts and keywords for in the coming series of the videos. So let me, I have already created a sample project folder such as a Cypress tutorial. Once we created a project folder, we can go to the terminal, and here you can see the project root such as Cypress tutorial is the project folder name. So we need to create a npm project and install, we need to run commands such as npm init. We can run this command to define the project configuration one by one, or to simplify the process, we can do the run the command npm init dash dash yes. So once we run this command, here you can see the configuration is automatically installed at a time with the name, Cypress tutorial, version, description, main, and npm scripts. Using the npm scripts, we can create commands and we can run, we can call them via command line. And keywords and author, we can define who is the author of the project, and license we can keep it as a default. On the left side you can see package.json was created, and here it is the configuration of the project. We can modify this project configuration in the package.json file. We can modify the npm scripts, we can define the dependencies manually as well, or we can run the command from terminal as well. So to install the Cypress, we need to run command npm, which stands for a node package manager. Or if we are using an package manager, we can do run the command and add Cypress. But in this series of the videos, mostly we will be using with the npm. So the command is npm install. We need to initialize that dev dependency. So we need to give the command save dev. If we are not using the installing as a dev dependency, then we don't need to define the save dev. But Cypress is a Cypress team suggested to install as a dev dependency. So we need to run the command save dev Cypress. So once we run this command, Cypress will be automatically installed in the local environment. If we want to install globally, we can define as npm install dash g Cypress. But the most recommended one is to install locally in the project configuration. Here you can see Cypress was installed with the version 4.9.0, and it is installed in the global version globally in the app cache, which is library caches. This is the binary version of the Cypress which will be installed in this path, and it will create a log.json file. And this file is to lock the module package versions. And with while doing the team collaboration, we need to commit this file so other team member can clone the project and use the same version of the node modules. And the Cypress latest version 4.9.0 was installed. Here you can see it created the dev dependencies and with Cypress version. If we are not using the dev dependency, it will be directly dependencies. But mostly recommended, we need to use the to install the Cypress as dev dependencies. In the local version, we can go to the node modules. We can expand the folder, and all the modules will be installed in the node modules folder. And here you can see Cypress will be installed locally. So we will be using the local Cypress. We need to run the command such as, and we can to open Cypress, we can run the command node modules in Cypress, and using this command we can open the Cypress terminal. But the most recommended one is the, let me clear this one. Using the npx cypress open. So using this command, we can open the Cypress test runner, and it will generate a bundle of packages with the pre-installed Cypress folders. So here npx stands for node package execution. So here you can see Cypress automatically generates an examples folder with the spec files such as actions, or how to handle cookies, how to handle files, how to create stubs, so how to handle create a viewports. So Cypress will automatically generate a examples folder. We can keep this folder, or we can delete this one and create the project related spec files. And the usage of browsers and the test runner configuration, I'll be covering in the next series of the videos. So let me close the test runner and clear the terminal. In the left side, you can see Cypress automatically created a folder framework structure and folders such as fixtures. Using the fixtures, you can call the data-driven testing using JSON file or CSV or XML file. Here you can see we can define the name and the value of the in the spec files, we can call this name, email, or body. In this way, we can define multiple test data and we can call the test data in the spec files. And integration folder is a subfolder of Cypress. And in the integration folder, there is a subfolder. We can define the subfolders such as examples or test files. And in the examples folder, we can see the spec files such as actions. Here it is a Cypress basic commands, cypress.visit, cypress.get. I'll be covering about Cypress basic commands in the next series of the videos. And plugin folder to define the plugins as a pre-hooks to execute before execution of the Cypress automation. And supports folder comes with the commands.js. Here we can create a number of reusable functions, cypress.commands.add, such as login or sign up. And we can call the reusable functions in the spec files. And the main file is the cypress.json file. Here we can define the project configuration, such as base URL, explicit timeouts, or any screenshots or any project configuration. For example, we can define the base URL. We can call the cypress.io. In the best practices, we always need to define the base URL in the cypress.json file instead of the spec file. Let me save the file. So, the package.json file, as I mentioned before, this is the main project configuration to install to create the NPM scripts and Java dependencies. And if you want to install any other modules, we can simply go to, let me open a tab and we can download. For example, if you want to download any other package such as Mocha or some reporter. So here you can see Mocha or some NPM from central repository, which is NPM is now a part of GitHub. So here there will be number of packages we can search, such as Mocha or some. Here is already is given. So Mocha or some is a custom reporter for used with the JavaScript testing framework such as Mocha. So we can install the Mocha awesome module with the command npm install, and here it's mentioned save dev, which is a dev dependency. We can copy this command and go to the terminal and we can run this command. So once we run this command, Mocha awesome will be installed locally as a dev dependency. So using this npm install, saved, we can install multiple number of dependencies from the central repository. Here you can see Cypress was previously installed and the latest one, Mocha awesome, with the version 6.1.1. This symbol stands for the latest version. Here we can define the manually. If you want to install the latest version, we can define here itself as well, or we can keep it as command. We can, using the command line, we can install the latest version as well. So in this video, I have covered Cypress setup and installation, Node.js, VS Code installation, and to getting started with Cypress. So in the next coming series, I'll be covering about Cypress, how to get started with Cypress basic commands, and from scratch to advanced JavaScript functions, VS Code IDE, usage and shortcuts and keywords. Stay tuned and take care. Bye.